in my conscience. My trap is still fucking, we got all these hundreds. Hit up the whole pharmacist. We serve all the money, my shit at your buddy. We shot at my buddy. This guy keep on falling, the drugs I keep calling. He keep picking up for me.
How you doing, ladies and gentlemen? This is Indeed Gaming here. I am, in fact, Mr. Indeed, and welcome to my channel. Please do comment on and share this video, and we are going to get right into it. Now, this video is going to be about expanding the bounty hunter role correctly, at least in my opinion. And we're going to be doing so in the obvious way, the way that has been rumored, the way that people have been asking for, the lawman role. And what I want to do here is pretty much explain that the difference between being a lawman and being a bounty hunter basically is that you're going to be catching people in the act of the crime instead of catching people who have just done crimes before. And to be fair, these people have done crimes before, but your missions are going to be more towards catching people in the act. And to be fair, there are some legendary missions, legendary bounties, and I want to say a regular bounty, where you are kind of catching people in the act, but we want to expand on that more. And basically that means that your missions, instead of catching somebody who is just some particular person who is famous for, I don't know, robbing trains or something like that, or killing people, you're going to be catching people in the act of robbing a train or robbing a bank. And it's not going to be geared towards a specific person. It may be geared towards a specific gang of outlaws or something like that, and they may have a particular leader, but it's going to be more geared towards you stopping crimes than catching one particular person who has done crimes. So some missions you may walk away from and not have caught anybody. Some missions will have more high value targets that you do have the choice to capture. And if you capture these people, depending on what their crime was, you can, one, have missions that are going to be you taking them to be hung. And then that mission will end with you protecting that area of them being hung. Their gang members may be, there may be still be some of them left, and they try to save them. I mean, we had missions like that in the main story. Except this time you'll be on the opposite end of it. So that's going to be really what you want to do with this role. You're also I would like to have... It started by you actually getting your own building. So you have like your own like little jailhouse that you have your own cells in, and you bring your criminals to your own cell. And you can actually also put missions into it where you have your jail wagon and you take them to the prison that you started the game in. So obviously that's if they're not being hung. There's a bounty hunter mission where like you kind of catch somebody who's like a murderer in Saint Denis, and like when you get there, he's like choking somebody out, and he sees you and he runs. That's more what we're looking for: people who are doing crimes, not just people who have done them. So it would be like bank robberies, train robberies, murders, robbing mansions and stuff like that. There's a couple of mansions here. Just gang members attacking a town or something like that. Maybe a sheriff needs help for whatever reason. And your job would pretty much be to help them. And that's pretty much what we're going to do with the missions. And now to get into the rewards. And the rewards are going to change the role, I would say, significantly and make it more interesting. The only issue is that it'd be a lot of programming that I'd be really surprised if it did, but this is super duper wishlist stuff. So, say level 10, technically level 40 because we're at Bounty Hunter level 30 now, but level 10 of the expansion, you would get a dog. I know everybody wants a dog in the game, so do I. So at level 10, you would get this dog who can help you track. So instead of when you're tracking a bounty, or even in the open world when you're tracking an animal or something like that, your dog would be able to track it for you. So you could come up to that area or whatever. You'd have to do the Red Dead mode so you can see it. And then you tell your dog, hey, track. So now instead of you having to track in the Red Dead mode, your dog's going to sniff it out. And then all you have to do is follow your dog. Now, at that point, your dog, as soon as all the fighting starts, he runs away. But then when you hit level 15 or level 45, now you get a pamphlet and your dog will learn to start helping you during these fights. So he'll be able to bite people, maybe even get the same animation the wolves have when they jump on top of you, unfortunately, and rip your neck out. And then level 20 or level 50 of the bounty hunter role, which will be the ultimate role, and this will be the ultimate super duper wish list, probably not going to happen stuff, is you get to make your own two deputies. So you're not just going to get two randomly generated, ridiculously ugly deputies. You're going to get two deputies that you get to create, and they can help you on big missions. And they can also be sent on missions. So if you send them on a mission, obviously they may fill up your jail cells, and then that'll be another way that kind of fills up your cell to a point where you need to take them to, you either need to take them to the prison or you need to take them to be hung and protect that area. And also it's possible that you can, they can be captured. So then a mission will be you having to go and save them. So similar to like how when you go to your moonshiner shack, you have particular missions that are there when you go and talk to the lady. There'll be always be at least one of the deputies at your building that can give you a mission. So if the mission is, can tell you about a mission. I don't say give you a mission because he works for you. So hey man, chill out. But basically, there's always going to be one deputy there, and that deputy can set up the mission for you. So if the mission is, hey, we captured this criminal, we need to take him to the prison, that's how you would get that from that deputy. If one of your deputies has gotten captured, the deputy who is there will be the one to tell you, and then either you and the deputy or just you can go and save him. And then obviously, you can still get like your regular kind of bounty pamphlets, or you can go to a actual sheriff in one of the towns and they can tell you about crimes that are in progress and stuff like that. But that's pretty much how you're going to be getting your missions and how that that role is going to roll. So let me know if you guys think that these are good ideas, and if you have any more ideas, let me know in the comment section. And if it expands on it or they're good ideas, I will make another video and we can continue to expand what we want the lawman role to be. And hopefully the devs see it and they at least consider parts of it, you know? All right, but that's the end of the video. I am going to keep the rest of the gameplay in the background just in case you guys want to finish watching it. And I will see you guys in the next one. Andy. Come on.
regret this. You will regret touching me. Now you have me. You are good.
Choke them! I want them dead!
Well, you'll get the going rate as soon as they're in a cell. Take them down there. Payment's here.